Apple's camera improvements have always pushed the limits of mobile photography, but the iPhone 18 Pro is about to get something very new. We've seen small advancements over the years, like improved sensors, better picture processing, and more advanced computational photography. The most recent supply chain intelligence suggests that a major change will happen in 2026. Recent claims from Apple's manufacturing partners go beyond the typical rumors. According to ET News, Apple has told its suppliers that it expects to use variable aperture technology in the iPhone 18 series. This isn't just another guess from an analyst. It's the first time for any iPhone, and it might be a big step forward, like when Apple added several lenses. What makes this more important is that supply chain activity now matches what industry expert Ming-Chi Kuo said would happen before. This level of collaboration shows that Apple has evolved from making little changes to making substantial plans for production 2 years from now. Let's be clear about the problem it solves. Currently, iPhone Pro models from the iPhone 14 through iPhone 17 generations feature fixed apertures of f/1.78, with the lens always completely open, like a window stuck at one size. Useful, definitely, but not for every lighting scenario. Variable aperture flips that script. The technology permits dynamic modification of light entering the sensor by physically opening or closing the device. Think of your eye's pupil. It tightens on a beach around lunchtime, then opens in a dim cafe. The important problem, though, is creative control. Today, when you photograph portrait mode on an iPhone, shallow depth of field features are commonly produced by image processing. With variable aperture, you get real optical bokeh without the software guesswork. The technology also allows photographers better control over depth of field, providing effects you can attain with DSLR cameras. Crisp landscapes, naturally blurred portraits, and the ability to choose a middle ground when it matches the scenario. This is not merely Apple testing concepts in a lab. Multiple industrial partners are already working on different aspects of the new camera system. The responsibilities are split with intent. LG Innotek and Foxconn will make the main camera module with variable aperture capability, while Chinese manufacturers Luxshare ICT and Sunny Optical will offer the actuator. Notably, Apple added Sunny Optical to its supply chain last year, a move that now appears like groundwork for this precise capability. Pulling this out needs tight choreography across optics, actuators, and integration hardware. It corresponds with claims that Apple finished its installation designs and currently works with suppliers to market the essential components and modules. Apple's timing matches a common pattern: let others go first, then tweak. Samsung Electronics previously incorporated variable aperture cameras in its Galaxy S9 and Galaxy S10 models in 2018 and 2019, but Samsung stopped the technology in 2020 due to concerns about increasing camera thickness and higher manufacturing costs. The pieces have gotten smarter since those early attempts. While the Galaxy S9 and S9 Plus allow the user to adjust between f/1.5 and f/2.4 apertures, current Android flagship phones such as the Xiaomi 14 Ultra offer a 50-megapixel main camera with f/1.63 to f/4.0 stepless variable aperture. The Xiaomi 14 Pro, debuted in late 2023, had an f/1.42 to f/4.0 variable aperture camera, indicating that miniaturized mechanics have evolved forward. Apple's proposal provides solutions to the thickness and cost trade-offs that tripped up Samsung, with the extra promise of greater integration with Apple's computational photography pipeline. If they nail the handoff, the user won't need to think about it. The phone will. 4. Why 2026 makes strategic sense for Apple. The schedule aligns up. The technology should appear in the iPhone 18 Pro and iPhone 18 Pro Max models, set for sale in fall 2026, which allows Apple time to polish production and harden reliability. The implementation is targeted where it counts. The variable aperture will be built into the main wide-angle camera of the Pro models, and it will sit alongside the existing ultra-wide and telephoto cameras in the 3-camera system. Familiar layout, more flexible main lens. It is also a competitive play. Apple's choice to incorporate variable aperture technology is considered as a strategic effort to differentiate its camera performance in an increasingly saturated smartphone market. As software advantages converge across flagships, hardware like this becomes the new scoreboard. This signals a transition in Apple's camera philosophy from pure computational domination to a tighter hardware plus software balance. A variable aperture allows for actual bokeh effects without post-processing, which solves the strange edges and background smearing that can pop up with portrait mode. For photographers, it is straightforward. More control over the depth of field in images, allowing for a shallow, medium, or deep DOF in very conditions. Use broader settings for low light or dreamy portraits. Stop down for crisp group pictures or landscapes. Less compromise, more intention. The ripple impact could be broad. Apple adopting variable aperture will push rivals to sharpen their own implementations, and Apple's software stack gives it a runway to make the experience feel invisible. I would expect a new standard for what a phone camera can do, more camera than phone in the best manner. The iPhone 18 Pro's variable aperture camera signifies more than a specification boost. It might be the next big leap in mobile photography, bringing iPhone cameras closer to the optical flexibility and creative control long associated with specialist camera systems. When Apple releases a camera function, the rest of the industry tends to follow, and this one could reset expectations. Apple's iPhone 18 series rumors imply a smaller dynamic island, but no underscreen face ID or front camera. Leaks from Weibo's Instant Digital imply the feature may appear in iPhone 19 Pro. With the iPhone 18 a year away, leaks and conjecture are sure to continue. The iPhone 17 generation, the Pro Max model, at least, is reported to have a smaller dynamic island thanks to some Medlens tech. However, the dynamic island will stay visible this year. Next year, however, with the iPhone 18 Pro series, things will start to change, reports the usual Weibo leakster account Digital Chat Station from China. The iPhone 18 Pro and Pro Max will have 6.27 and 6.86 OLED displays, respectively. Those will be LTPO screens with 1.5K resolution and will utilize whole inactive area technology for the selfie camera and an under-display face ID system. The whole inactive area is the familiar punch hole design where part of the pixel matrix of the display is removed to provide a camera lens underneath a clear view. This is widely established at this point, but the technology to transfer face ID is not. Face ID is a combination of a projector, which beams a pattern of infrared light, a flood illuminator, also works in infrared, and a camera to see the infrared light. This might or might not work with existing under-display camera hardware, since that is optimized for visible light, not infrared. However, Apple fixed this issue. It is supposedly currently testing prototypes. Such a shift has been rumored for a long time now, as far back as the iPhone 15 generation. There were similar reports for succeeding models, including the iPhone 17 generation, but it's not happening until next year. That is providing no unanticipated complications pop up, of course. So, that's all we know for now. We'll be sure to keep you updated as soon as we have more information. Thanks for watching.